me this, I'm gonna ask it right back. Everybody on my team plays a role, yeah. And we have to encourage teamwork. Mm-hmm. How does Huawei encourage teamwork?
Yeah, you know, like a lot of the big companies has the saying that we encourage teamwork, but I'm actually quite proud to see Huawei actually really embeds it in the way it operates. Although it's rooted in China, but it's operating more than 170 countries. And in every local offices, more than 70% of the employees are locally hired and completely developed in local places. So that diversity I see is quite unique. And it's kind of similar as the people in your team too.
Yeah. What is the history of the company? Like, mm-hmm. Can you tell me how long have you been around and the history?
Yeah, it's quite amazing that Huawei was actually founded in 1987. So it's already more than 30 years. And even now, like, China's digital economy is it's really leading the whole world. But back then in 1987, that was a time that China almost has one of the most severe poverty rate and the lowest telephone penetration rate. So there was a huge demand for telecom industry. So that's how Huawei started. And given like the fact that it has been here for more than 30 years, it really has a really strong survival DNA and resilience. Also because the really special feature that it's 100% owned by its own employees. And the founder never chose to put the company in the stock market. It's never listed on stock market.
Wow.
So as a technology company, it's able to make longer term decision about R&D.
Yeah.
So that's also something that I see really a really cool factor.
Yeah.
I managed to go so yeah,
that's amazing. So far. Who do you think is your biggest competitor mm-hmm. at the moment?
That's also a really interesting question because Huawei never comments on competitors. But meanwhile, we always welcome to have more competitors.
So you never really say who your competitor is, but no. You are motivated by what these other companies are doing, and it's like, let's step up our game and raise the bar, and then they have to try to do the same.
Yeah, I think everyone needs more competition. We need open competition in this industry.
Yeah.
For the whole industry to have more progress.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah, competition makes us all better. We need
yeah.
it.
It's funny that actually, as I said, that we actually want more collaboration mm-hmm. among competitors to put the standard for the overall societal progress.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's quite a unique industry.
It really is. That's
yeah.
amazing.
Yeah.
We need to take that on in sports. What
okay.
do you think is the next big thing that mm-hmm. tech can solve?
So as I said, I think technology is only sexy when it actually combines with different pain points in different population and industries. So when you actually combine the technology and the know-how in different industries, that's when you actually see the value. Let's say 5G, right? We only know it's fast. Then we combine 5G with different industries. Say mining industry, like last year, we have been using 5G in mining industry to replace some really dangerous work that people need to do before. So now 5G allows remote working. So it's by really improving worker safety, but also improving the overall productivity.
What challenges do you see the company facing right now in the market?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are some of your biggest challenges? And I guess, where do you see it going after hopefully solving these challenges?
Yeah, I think one of the biggest challenges is open competition, right? It's like sports. Competitions make everyone better.
Mm-hmm.
So not being able to compete openly, like the whole technology progress is sacrificing a lot. Because like I said before, Huawei was actually mainly helping rural areas in US, the part that's more costly for other vendors to do.
We got to get everybody connected.